Welcome to this series of videos on accessibility requirement for public procurement of ICT products and services in Europe, the EN301549 standard. This is the second video. It's sponsored by Microsoft and produced by Funka. My name is Susanna Loren. I'm an accessibility expert with a long experience in standardization. In this video, we are going to take a closer look on how you can integrate accessibility into the procurement process. How does procurement fit into the value chain of an ICT project? How can suppliers use the EN standard? And how can procurers use it? And how can you control the deliverables? Integration of accessibility in the procurement process. The first thing you have to keep in mind is that accessibility is not an activity. It's a part of every step along the way and every decision that is made. Everything from user situation to technology, from design to code, do have an impact on the accessibility. An example might make this clearer. Let's say that we need a new ticket system for the buses in town. If we decide that users need to buy their ticket from a machine, this will make it hard for some users to complete the task. So the decision made actually affects the whole context of the service. A ticket machine needs to be placed in a public environment, and this will restrict the design. If we mount it too high, that will cause problems for some users. And accessibility problems in the software will cause problems for other users. Some of these issues can be handled through a good procurement process. But it's important to realize that decisions made both before procurement and after procurement will affect the accessibility of the service. And it's also important to know that you need to keep a lot of details in your head to be successful in the procurement of accessibility. The procurement is just one step in the process, but it's an important step since this is where many of the requirements are defined. It will become both difficult and expensive, and sometimes even impossible to correct the errors afterwards. The EN301549 standard is made to help you ensure accessibility in the product or service that you are about to buy. This way, all users, no matter of ability, can use it. Accessibility requirements are, in a way, quality and efficiency assurance. Who wants to buy something that is not possible to use? There has been a need for something to help procurers when buying accessible ICT products and services for a long time. The difficulties have been that we have different standards in different markets. We have different standards in different sectors. And we also have different standards for similar products. Today, procurers and suppliers in many cases only have a vague understanding about accessibility, but not exactly what it means or how to ensure that it is being delivered. The EN301549 is here to help both procurers and suppliers to get a common understanding on what requirements are needed to achieve accessibility. The standard doesn't give you all the answers, but it is a help, and it does include a lot of the things that are important for accessibility. In the European Member States, it's mandatory to use a technical standard for accessibility requirement in public procurement, and the EN301549 is the best we have. The EN301549 contains a wide range of requirements to cover a wide variety of ICT solutions. There are requirements on function, physical characteristics, and software. Each procurement situation needs to define which requirements are relevant for that specific product or service. In the next video, we will take a closer look at the structure of the standard. But let's start with the roles concerned and how they can use the standard. For you as a supplier, standards and requirements may be perceived as tiresome and dull, but in reality, it makes procurement a fair play between competitors, and common standards make life easier for suppliers. So let the best offer win, and see the standard as a tool that helps you to do the right thing. As a supplier, you know how difficult life can be. Either there are no accessibility requirements at all in the procurement, because the procurer thinks it is self-evident, or there are no accessibility requirements because the procurers are not aware of accessibility issues. Most often, there are some reference to accessibility, but far too vague for you as a supplier to understand the detailed meaning of. It could say, should follow accessibility standards or should be accessible. But this is, of course, a nightmare for suppliers because it can be interpreted in many different ways. With EN 301549, this risk is minimized since there are very concrete requirements. This makes it easier for you and your fellow companies developing ICT products and services to verify that the solutions meet all the requirements and thereby are accessible. This makes it easier and less resource-consuming for you to answer the call for tenders, because requirements will all be the same. Isn't that sweet? Today, requirements may vary between tender specifications for similar products, but if public procurers use the same requirements, you don't have to re-evaluate the same solution twice. With a common standard of minimum requirements, you as a supplier can compete with being the most accessible, if that is your edge. Or you can compete in all other aspects, resting assured that you and your competitors will be fairly weighted in the procurement process. With a standardized set of requirements, it also becomes meaningful to let an independent party verify that a particular solution does meet the requirements, opening up for certification processes, both of products and consultants. This is a small checklist for suppliers. Start now and be proactive. If you want to sell to public sector, you will sooner or later need to meet the accessibility requirements of EN 301549. If you don't know the accessibility status of your offering today, take the first step, otherwise you will never get there. The standard provides an instrument to measure the degree of accessibility of your product or service. If you use an independent party to verify that your solution meets the requirements, neither you nor your clients will have to worry about it. And you can concentrate on creating something wonderful to sell instead of having procurement trouble. Compete with usability and accessibility. If you bring accessibility into the DNA of your business, this will not cost you more resources or hassle. Look at it as a way of making sure your solution can be used by as many as possible. That should be perceived as a selling point. How can a procurer use the EN standard? As a procurer, you can make sure that the tenders will be possible to compare on fair grounds when everyone is answering to the same requirements. You benefit just as much as the suppliers when using EN 301549. The standard makes it much easier to ensure that the procurement process includes accessibility requirements. You don't have to be an expert on all aspects of accessibility. You don't have to include different guidelines for a physical product or a software. You only have to require that the solution meets the standard. That's efficient and secure. When the whole purchasing power of public sector across the EU use the same requirements, the market will react. If your organization were the only one trying to procure something accessible, there would be difficulties finding suppliers that could comply with them. But when EN 301549 is in broad use, suppliers that want to sell to public sector will be compared at what level of accessibility they provide, which means that you as a procurer will have more accessible solutions to choose from. A common standard for accessibility requirements also means that it becomes much easier to check if you have actually got what you asked for. The market for third-party audits will raise, making it cheaper to get help when needed. And all experts will know exactly what they are looking for, so you don't have to worry that there is some kind of subjective feeling around what is accessible. The standard tells you what the minimum requirements are. Very clear. If you do not check what you get, you can be sure that you do not get what you expected. There are many reasons why accessibility fails in an ICT product or service. Problems can occur by mistake, because of ignorance, lack of time or money, or a bunch of other reasons. But for you to make sure that what you buy has the best possible chances of working for as many users as possible, you need to make an acceptance test, including controlling accessibility requirements are met according to the terms of reference. This is really important. As a procurer, you need to be clear on the requirements from the beginning. If you want the solution to meet the requirements, they need to be in there from the start. But it's also important to follow up on that the solution you get does meet the requirements. If you explain in the beginning of the project that you will follow up on requirements, the probability that the solution will be accessible increases immensely. If you don't know how to verify accessibility, you should ask for help. It's better to invest a small sum verifying that you get what you ordered in the project than trying to retrofit accessibility afterwards. When you procure something that is going to be customized, like a website, accessibility requirements need to be checked in every phase. The decision about the level of accessibility beyond the basic requirements in the standard should be up to you as a procurer to make. If you let the supplier decide, you will lose control. Accessibility can fail for many, sometimes seemingly small, reasons, so do check each step along the way. If you haven't done this before, or if you don't know the requirements well enough, you need to have someone responsible for accessibility during the project. It can be difficult to see that a particular decision in the beginning might lead to problems in the end. But by using a common standard for procuring accessibility ICT products and services, at least all parties will know the game plan. Small checklist for procurers. Make sure to use the standard and specify exactly what functionality or result you are looking for, so the suppliers can understand it. Make sure suppliers are aware of that you will control that the solution meets the requirements. Check that you get what you ordered. When you procure something that is dynamic, this needs to be done within each phase. In the next video, we will look at the structure of the standard, what types of requirements are included, and the relationship between them. Thanks for watching.